after this. Same thing. Stay focused. You guys know you can do this.
It's nothing that matters that we did early in the season. It's all about the here and the now, in the present.
In her 16th season as head coach at Georgia, Suzanne Yoakland is in the process of building a dynasty. The defending national champions are led by the talented Litchie sisters, Karen and Christy. For Val Condos and UCLA, a 1997 championship has inspired the Bruins to seek a second national title. 96 champions and Georgia's arch-rival Alabama is also here. It's the 1999 NCAA Women's Gymnastics Championships. We're in the Huntsman Center on the campus of the University of Utah, site of the 1999 NCAA Women's Gymnastics Championship. I'm Bill McAtee. Welcome to Salt Lake City, where the story has been the continuing dominance of the University of Georgia. They are, of course, the defending national champions. They haven't lost as a team in the last 2 years. They won the preliminaries, so they head the Super Six, vying for the national championship today. The Super Six consists of Georgia, Michigan, UCLA, Alabama, Nebraska, and Arizona State. One team conspicuously absent, the University of Utah. They struggled on the balance beam during the preliminaries. They were never able to recover. So for the second time in the last 3 years, Utah fails to make the Super Six. I'm pleased today to be joined by 1996 Olympic gold medalist Amanda Borden. And Amanda, I know you, along with everyone here, is very impressed by Georgia.
How can you not be impressed with a team like Georgia? Today, they're led by the sister duo of Karen and Christy Litchie. But what makes them exceptional is that they have the difficulty and they perform it consistently.
Well, there's an awful lot of talent on the floor today. Name the teams that you think can give Georgia a run.
I think that UCLA and Michigan are going to make it difficult for Georgia to win. UCLA is led by Heidi Moneymaker. She's recovering from two ankle sprains, but she performed very well in the preliminaries. And from Michigan, they're led by Sarah Kane. They're not a flashy team. They come out, they perform their routines very clean without mistake, and that's what's going to keep them in contention.
And the other team worth keeping an eye on is the University of Alabama. They're seeded number two, but they really struggled during the preliminaries. Well, here's a look at the first rotation. Georgia will start with the vault, Alabama on the bars. Michigan draws the beam to start, and UCLA will be on the floor. Suzanne Yoakland, 16th year at the University of Georgia, three-time NCAA Coach of the Year. And Amanda Curry, now up on the vault for Georgia, sophomore from Houston.
Separation, but a very good landing. Watch right here as she opens out of her pipe, her legs separate just a little bit. It'll be a small deduction.
Amanda, an honor student and class president, Taylor High School in Houston. There's Sarah Patterson, 21 years at Alabama. Three national championships. They've lost three times to Georgia this year, so Sarah knows that Alabama will need to pull off something special if they're to challenge Georgia today. Meanwhile, Gwen Spidell of Alabama on the bars.
Her required release move, a Jaeger flip, nicely done. Back up to the high bar, getting ready for her dismount. Hitting up some speed. Wow, great half-in, half-out dismount. Nice routine by Gwen.
Well, this is a difficult spot. First up on the beam from Michigan, Beth Malkovich, who's a senior, academic All-American, and she'll try to set the tone for Michigan here.
Being first up on beam is a very difficult position. It sets the entire outlook for beam for the entire team. If she hits, it takes pressure off the next person. Beth is a senior. She's experienced. With her series, you can tell she's confident. Pitch kick right into a full twisting wolf jump. It's a gym series. Every girl is required to perform a flight series, which is a tumbling skill, as well as a gym series, which is jumps. Cat leap right into a side summy. She's definitely solid here today. Preparing for a dismount. Back handspring, one and a half. Being her team, you can tell she's excited about that one.
Well, here's the number for Gwen Spidell, 9.775, and a very solid 9.825 for Betha Malkovich. Over on the floor exercise, Allison Stoner, UCLA has already had a poor score in the floor. Valerie Velasco was up first, and she scored a 9.675, so a little more pressure now on Allison Stoner.
Setting up for a second tumbling pass.
Clutching her right knee. And Valerie Condos out there quickly, the head coach at UCLA and now the medical staff.
Watch her right knee when she lands. Just a slight twerk. That's all it takes.
Well, Allison is up and being helped off the mat. Freshman from Laguna Hills, California, and she's been one of UCLA's top performers in the floor exercise, averaging a 9.8 in her last seven meets, and a nice ovation from the crowd here in Salt Lake City as we're underway at the Huntsman Center.
CBS Sports presents the NCAA Women's Gymnastics Championships. Sponsored by Pennzoil with PureBase. Made for the way you drive. Stop, go, Pennzoil. Febreze. Febreze cleans bad smells out of fabrics for good. And by Little Caesars.
Hi, Mom. I just want to wish you a happy Mother's Day. I love you.
Happy Mother's Day from the University of Michigan. We love you.
Wishing all the mothers in America a happy Mother's Day, and a special one to my mom back in Tuscaloosa.
And some of the Alabama moms looking on here at the Huntsman Center. Over on bars, Dara Stewart from Alabama, sophomore.
She is an All-American on this event. Huge Tkachev. She had a career high of a 9.95, so let's see if she can do it again today. Back up to the high bar, preparing for a dismount. Nice double layout, great landing.
Hugs all around after a very solid routine. Over on the floor, Heidi Moneymaker. Remember, she has the ankle injuries, both ankles.
She actually told me that floor is the hardest event on her ankles, but you couldn't tell that here today.
A junior and in many ways the spiritual leader of this UCLA team. Now, UCLA needs a very strong score from Heidi because they'll have to count the 9.65 in floor. Six routines for each team. They throw out the low and count the top five, but because of the injury to Allison Stoner, that will be the low score.
Getting ready for her last pass. Each routine is about a minute and a half long, so they have to have a lot of endurance. Nice clean double full.
Heidi Moneymaker, and there's her mom, Casey Moneymaker, looking on. The numbers up for Dara Stewart of Alabama in the bars, 9.85. For Heidi Moneymaker of UCLA, 9.80. And Kathy Burke fell on the beam, so her score is a 9.3. Let's see what happened.
This is her flight series, a back handspring layout. Watch her hips and her shoulders. The most important thing, keep in mind the beam's only 4 inches wide, to keep your hips and shoulders on top of the beam, and that didn't happen right.
While Heidi Moneymaker was on the floor, Sarah Kane was next up on the beam, and of course, a lot of pressure on Sarah here because you get one fall. They throw out the low, and Michigan obviously has now had that fall, so everyone else has to stay on the apparatus.
If anybody can handle the pressure, Sarah Kane can.
How difficult is it not to focus on the fact that you don't want to fall and to keep your focus on your routine itself?
That's one of the most important things about beam is approaching the beam, knowing that you're going to make the routine, not having any doubt in your head. Require leap series, pitch kick to switch side half.
Sarah was a first-team All-American on the beam in 1997.
Getting ready for a dismount here. Wow. A nice round of throwback. That's a very difficult dismount. Great landing.
Christy Litchie, the sophomore, one of the Litchie sisters, now up on the vault.
Nice pipe front half. Very clean and a great, great landing.
The ever-present Suzanne Yocklin cheering on her athletes. Sarah Kane, 9.825. Christy Litchie in the vault scores a 9.9. Now on the floor from UCLA, the senior co-captain, the Pac-10 Gymnast of the Year, Kira Lee Hayashi.
Second pass is a round off whip through to double back. Also required to do a leap series, so you have three tumbling passes as well as leaps and dance. The routine here is also at least has to be a minute and 10, and the longest it can be is a minute and a half. A lot of the girls said that the altitude has been affecting them. As you can see here, this is time for her to breathe and get prepared for that last pass. Ending with a nice double full.
Kira Lee Hayashi and UCLA making a nice comeback after a disappointing start in the floor exercise. Mom and Dad, Lynette and Patrick Hayashi looking on. Rising star at the University of Alabama has been Andrea Pickens, and we asked Sarah Patterson about her outstanding freshman.
She's one of the most explosive athletes that I've ever coached before, and I think her uneven bar routine and her vaulting are some of the best in the country.
Well, Alabama doing very well on the bars to this point. Let's see if young Andrea can keep that going.
This move coming up is what makes her stand out. A Hindorf. Right into a Tkachev. Two release moves right down to the low bar. A very clean routine this far. Preparing for a dismount. Nice half in, half out.
Andrea Pickens, the freshman sensation from the University of Alabama. The number for Kiralee Hayashi on the floor, 9.9, and Andrea scores a 9.875 for Alabama on the bar. Over on the vault, Karen Litchie, who's ranked number one in the nation in the vault, also on the bars and floor. There's her father, Dave.
High handspring front half. Great landing. Karen scored a perfect 10 on this vault last year. Great height, nice opening, a very clean landing. Just a slight hop. There might be a small deduction.
And Suzanne Yocklin there every step of the way. Hug from sister Christy, and look at that, the score for Karen Litchie at 9.95, almost perfect. So the standings after the first rotation, Georgia, Alabama, Michigan, and UCLA. The third member of our broadcast team today is Bonnie Bernstein, and let's check in with Bonnie for a report.
An update now for you on UCLA freshman Allison Stoner. She injured her knee taking a bad landing in the first rotation on floor exercise. The early prognosis is she either has a tear of the medial collateral ligament or the anterior cruciate ligament. Now, this doesn't really affect UCLA because floor is the only event Stoner was competing, but it does alter the psyche of a UCLA team that's already under an immense amount of pressure, Bill.
All right, Bonnie, thank you very much. And we'll be back with more from Salt Lake City, Utah, in a moment. For late breaking news, scores, and complete sports coverage, go to cbs.sportsline.com or on America Online in a keyword CBS Sportsline. Back at Salt Lake City, and here's the lineup for the second rotation. UCLA will be on the vault, Nebraska on the bars, Alabama on the beam, and Arizona State will be on the floor exercise. And there's Dan Kindig, head coach at the University of Nebraska. Nebraska's second appearance in the Super Six. He wore a tuxedo the last time out, so that tradition continues. And Nicole Wilkinson will be up for Nebraska on the bars, a junior from Ontario, Canada.
I'm not really sure what happened. Sorry, she bent her legs and just kind of dropped off. I don't know if her hand slipped. Let's take a look here. Giant blind. Bent her legs. So probably about a 3-10 deduction. It actually looked like she didn't have enough pressure on her left arm, and that's why she had to bend her legs.
So she'll go back up, complete her routine.
She'll have to perform the same move again right here, giant blind, right into a Jaeger. Takes a lot of guts to perform the same skill she just messed up on again. Giant full, preparing for a dismount. Nice double layout, great landing. She had a problem in the beginning, but finished up great. That's too bad.
Over on the vault, Lena Dekteva of UCLA. Her sister Marina is on the gymnastics team at LSU, and they competed against each other for the first time here in the preliminaries.
Yurchenko Arabian. It's the first Yurchenko we've seen today. She actually enters the vault backwards. She does a round off onto the board.
Lena trained under her mother, Svetlana, in Canada. And here, Nicole Wilkinson score 9.2. And for Dekteva, 9.775. Elizabeth Reed, junior from Arizona State, on the floor exercise. Elizabeth, a four-time All-American and the 1997 NCAA champion on the beam.
Liz is actually a very tall gymnast. Totally different style of dance. A smooth tumbler. Front full through to a front.
Outstanding in the Super Six 2 years ago. Elizabeth led Arizona State to a second place finish behind UCLA.
She's actually a actually performing to the music from Riverdance. Kristen Smith, the assistant coach, actually choreographs his routines.
And a nice round of applause for Elizabeth Reed from Arizona State.
This is her opening pass, round off, whip, immediate double full. Great landing.
And the score for Elizabeth Reed, 9.85. Sarah Patterson awaiting Alabama's turn on the beam and very aware that Alabama struggled on the beam in the preliminaries with three falls.
Gwen Spidell lost it on her flight series. It just seemed like they couldn't get their focus back. Mandy Chapman fell on something as easy as a roll. And Robin Hawkins on a back handspring layout. They just couldn't pick it up after the first fall. Hopefully they can get it back together right here.
Alexa Martinez from Pflugerville High School in Texas, outside of Austin, on the beam for Alabama. Member of the U.S. national team in 1993.
That was an interesting move, a front roll. Right into a double stag jump. That's not something you see very often. That handspring pike, oh. That's not what Alabama needed right now. They needed to start out with a confident routine.
So an early disadvantage for Alabama. Over on the vault, Kiralee Hayashi, who's competing with a medical condition that causes her heart to race. And we asked her about that.
It's a form of an arrhythmia where my heart will beat faster than a normal heartbeat. Like sometimes they'll go up to 200 or more beats per minute, and it's kind of makes you feel a little nauseous. Sometimes it can be give you a lightheaded, you know. Just you kind of get a workout without actually really working out. You just sit there and your heart's beating really fast.
Kiralee talking to Val Condos. She set out the vault and the bars at the Pac-10 championships because of her condition. Nanette Hayashi, her mother, looking on.
Another round off entry vault. And Arabian, I believe it was supposed to be laid out. It looked like she's slightly tucked on the landing. Let's take another look. She does a round off onto the board, a back handspring onto the vault, and her leg's bent right there. That will be a deduction.
Score for Hayashi, 9.75. And the score for Alexa Martinez after the fall on the beam, 9.275 for Alabama.
Watch her hips and shoulders. Her shoulders are completely to the side of the beam, but she did everything possible to try to stay on, but it just didn't work for her today.
It looked like Alexa might stay on for just an instant. And the pressure is on Alabama once again.
Coach John Wooden came and spoke to our team. He just sat them down. He spoke with them about his pyramid of success, about how important balance is in life, about how important it is to be honest with yourself first. It was interesting to see our team sit down with this legend, get calm, and take his words and develop strength from them. It was one of the highlights of my life, not just my coaching career.
Special time spent with a legend, John Wooden. Up on the vault for UCLA, Heidi Moneymaker, and she is the national champion in this event.
Each vault has a start value, and Heidi is starting from a perfect 10 here today. Let's see what she does. A pike front half, great landing.
And the ankles continuing to hold up very well.
Let's watch here. She had a great pre-flight, nice height, and a good landing. Just a small hop.
Score for Moneymaker on the vault, a 9.9. And the troubles continue for Alabama on the beam. Robin Hawkins, a 9.15, and let's see what happened.
In the preliminaries, it was their flight series. Today, it was a straddle jump. Let's take a look from the end. Watch her right foot as she goes to land, crosses a little too far and just slips off.
So one of those falls will count for Alabama in a sense of deja vu for Sarah Patterson. Up next for Alabama, the freshman Andrea Pickens, biology major. She's from Houston. There's her father, Byron. Her mother, Denise, can't even look. Andrea was the co-national champion on beam this year.
Andrea can handle the pressure. She competed the 1996 Olympic trials, so she knows how to deal with it. To the strong opening mount, punch front on.
Andrea, one of two gymnasts here invited to the Olympic trials in 1996. Teresa Kulikowski of Utah is the other.
Nice flight here. She is solid today.
Andrea was fourth in the all-round competition.
It's her gym series, a switch split to a split quarter. She has no deductions so far. Wolf jump to a back handspring. Andrea has a huge dismount coming up. Round off, double back. The perfect landing. Wow. She handled the pressure great.
And Alabama was in need of a strong effort. And Andrea has delivered it. Denise finally able to turn and look, and we'll take another look.
This is her flight series. Back handspring, layout, step out. No deduction.
There's Byron. He knows it's good. And the score for Andrea Pickens, a 9.9. And Nebraska's troubles over on the bars continue. Heather Brink with a 9.3, and here's what happened.
Performing at Tkachev, her hands just didn't quite get over the bar. There's a better look. Reaching back into the bar, just didn't quite get a good enough grip to hang on.
Over on the floor, ranked number one in the nation in the floor exercise, is Elizabeth McNabb, a junior from Las Vegas, and a frequent study partner of Amanda Borden's.
That's right. More importantly, she's a good tumbler. She opened with a front, threw to double back. Performing to Evita.
We should note, I guess, that you're attending classes at Arizona State. Working with the gymnast there as well.
Nice double pike. Shushanova. Liz specializes only on floor and beam, so this is definitely one of her strengths. Ending with a nice double full, very clean. She actually scored her very first perfect 10 this year.
Elizabeth McNabb from Arizona State. The floor exercise. Getting ready for her vault is Mohini Hugo Hardwaz of UCLA.
She's performing a very difficult vault. Yurchenko 1.5. Great landing. It has a 10-0 start value, and it was very clean, so it should be a very good score.
For the 4'10 sophomore from Cincinnati. And the score for Elizabeth McNabb on the floor, a 9.9. The hard was with a 9.9 on the ball. Alabama heads to a bye after a disappointing showing on the beam. Here's a look at the standings after two rotations, but the more significant number would be the scoring average. It's Georgia, Arizona State, UCLA, and here's Bonnie Bernstein with UCLA's Val Condors.
Coach, you had mentioned because of the altitude in Salt Lake in the preliminary round, the girls were getting a little bit dizzy. How do you find they're adjusting?
It's not bad. I every team here is feeling it, besides probably Utah, so it's not an excuse at all. It's very dry, and they're having a hard time recovering, you know, from one event to another. It's, you know, the kids just went from floor to ball, and Kirley said, I my muscles feel fine, I just can't recover from the last floor routine, so it's not an excuse.
Going for your second national title in 3 years, what do you think the key will be the rest of the way?
They need to hit with confidence like we hit at Pac-10s and regionals. I mean, they came out with a vengeance, and with such confidence, there was no giving away any little tenth. And so if we can do that on bars and beam, we'll see how the scores fall.
Thanks, Val. Good luck.
Thank you, Bonnie. We'll be back after this message and a word from your local station. Back in Salt Lake City, and for more in-depth gymnastics news, go to cbs.sportsline.com on the internet. Inside Huntsman Center, set for the third rotation. Arizona State on the vault, Georgia on the bars, Nebraska on the beam, and Michigan on the floor exercise. Michigan trying to join Utah, Georgia, Alabama, and UCLA as the only teams to win national championships in gymnastics.
I feel like there are some people that aren't giving us the credit potentially that I think they know that we can put it together and be dangerous. I think that this group of individuals feel like they are putting it together finally, at the right time. They're going to be ready to compete, not for second, but they want to compete for a championship.
Well, Michigan is a senior-dominated team, and there's one of the seniors now, Kathy Burke. Floor exercise. Michigan finished first in the floor exercise in the preliminaries.
This is definitely one of Kathy's stronger events. She opens with a whip through to double tuck. Nice landing. This is an event where the girls can actually have some fun, show their personalities, get the crowd into it.
Michigan off to a good start in the floor exercise. Their best finish at the national championships, runner-up in 1995. Amanda Curry over on the bars, an 8.9. Let's see what happened.
Nice high Jaeger flip to shoot over. Here's the problem. Her feet hit the ground. That can be anywhere from 3/10 to 5/10 of a deduction. And on her dismount, a double front, just didn't quite get enough rotation. Now that's a 5/10 deduction for sure.
Kathy Burke on the floor for Michigan, a 9.8. And Lori McLaughlin of Nebraska disappointed after an 8.5 on the beam. And remember, Nebraska struggled on the bars.
She didn't even get to finish her series. She was crooked on her second back handspring. And here again, a gainer layout. Foot not square on the beam. She lost it again.
Up on the beam now for Nebraska, Misty Oxford, senior from Kelso, Washington. She's a three-time All-American, but has struggled recently with a severe muscle pull in her stomach.
Their coach actually said that she's an athlete that nothing can stop her. It's very painful, but she said she wants to be here competing with her team. So far, but she's staying on, and that's what counts for Nebraska right now. Wolf jump to back handspring, that's a required gym acro. Getting ready for her dismount. Actually something we haven't seen today. She's going to be dismounting off the side of the beam. It's a gainer, full twist, great landing.
And Nebraska needed a solid routine, and they got it from Misty Oxford. Kelly Christensen, sophomore from Tempe, a transfer from BYU, up on the vault for Arizona State.
Nice pipe, handspring front, great landing. But this vault only starts at a 9.9, so if she performed it perfect, she could only score a 9.9.
9.8 for Misty Oxford of Nebraska on the beam. For Kelly Christensen, 9.775 on the vault. Christy Litchie waiting at the bars, competing together with Sister Karen for the last time on the collegiate level today, and they have been Georgia's 1-2 punch in gymnastics.
The Litchie sisters, they're night and day, definitely. They're the odd couple. Christy's got this real subtle sarcasm to her that's really fun. Karen's, you know, what you see is what you get.
We live together, we train together, and she's just been by my side this whole year, helping me out, not only mentally, but physically. She just tells me little key words or little things that just have made me more successful this year. Our relationship has really grown these last 2 years since we have been on the team together, and, you know, I'm going to miss her next year.
At UCLA earlier this year, Christy took the all-round title. Karen finished second. It was the first time in women's collegiate gymnastics history that sisters took first and second overall in a meet.
It should be interesting to see what happens to Christy when Karen leaves. They've competed together for years, and now Christy will be the team leader. Nice giant folded ginger. A little bit of a leg separation. Georgia needs to be clean at this point. They don't want to have to count a low score. Winding up for her dismount. Double layout. Couple steps, not quite as clean as I think they would have liked it to have been, but she hit the routine and that's what counts. Watch here on the landing of her dismount. She takes 2 steps backwards. That will be 0.2 of a deduction.
So Christy's score, 9.675, and they will have to count that. So perhaps some concern at Georgia with Karen Litchie coming up.
Once a week, the team gets together, and two girls come every Wednesday. They sign on. Carlene gives us the questions, and we type in our own answers.
Who do you think the strongest teams in the competition are, apart from UGA, of course?
Utah, UCLA, Michigan.
Here we go.
There you go, Chris.
There you go. I'm a 22-year-old sophomore at BYU. I've been following Christy, or Chris, as I call her, for 2 years now.
That's the crazy one.
Ask him if he's cute.
What do you look like?
Chat with the Gym Dogs. That took place every Wednesday during the season. And women's gymnastics, so popular at the University of Georgia, they had 600 people show up for an inter-squad scrimmage before the season started. Now on the bars, Karen Litchie. And Georgia is in need of a solid routine on the bars.
Nice giant full. Jaeger flip in the pike position. Karen has a difficult routine, but she performs it very cleanly. Getting ready for a dismount. Nice double layout. Perfect landing. Wow. Georgia needed that routine right there.
As has happened so often, Karen Litchie delivers for the Georgia Gym Dogs. Over the floor exercise for the University of Michigan, Sarah Kane. Sarah's a junior from Grand Island, Nebraska. She was an All-American in the floor exercise in 1998.
Opening with a great pass, a 1.5 through the double tuck, and immediately coming back. Back handspring half through to a Rudy. Wow, very nice.
Michigan trying to keep it close. Karen Litchie scoring the bars. Wow, 9.95. That's just what Georgia needed.
Here we go.
Sarah Kane on the floor, 9.85. And Nebraska's troubles continue. Nicole Wilkinson struggling on the beam.
Her flight series, back handspring, you can see she was completely off. She had no chance of staying on.
Amy Shelton, junior from Arizona State, up next on the vault. She's ASU's top vaulter, averaging a 9.86.
Amy has a 10-0 vault. Handspring pike front half.
And remember, Amy's the one who brought ASU into the Super Six on the very last vault of the prelims, knocking out LSU.
She did have a little bit of a leg separation and a step on the landing, so those are both deductions.
Strong board.
And the score for Amy Shelton, 9.75. Over on the floor exercise, the senior from Michigan, Nikki Peters.
Talk about dynamics. Watch this opening pass. Done.
And with a good score, Michigan can stay close to UCLA for second place.
Preparing for a second tumbling pass. Rhonda whip pass. Front layout. Immediately into a Shushanova. Time to have a little fun. That's what it's all about, right? Nice job.
Well, will that be enough to keep Michigan close to UCLA behind the University of Georgia? And speaking of Georgia, there's Jenny Bethard now on the bars, and she's the SEC champion in bars, scored two perfect 10s on bars this year. Academic All-SEC. Very solid performer for Georgia.
Great opening. Nice to Kachev. Oh, she did hit her feet on the ground, and that is a deduction. Another upright handstand, just a little bit short. Preparing for a dismount. Nice half in, half out. Another step on the landing. Georgia is definitely leaving the doors open here. They're not being as clean as they need to be.
Nikki Peters scored a 9.9 on the floor for Michigan. And Jenny Bethard on the bars, a 9.75 for Georgia. So the standings after three rotations, Georgia, UCLA, Michigan, Alabama, and Arizona State tied for fourth, and Nebraska is sixth. Georgia with the lead, but they've still got the beam, and that's coming up next. The individual apparatus champions have been decided. Last year's bars champion, UCLA's Heidi Moneymaker, dominated the vault this year, surprising even herself.
I knew there was a chance I might make the vault finals, so last week I decided to learn a new vault, and it worked for me.
Utah's Angie Leonard provided the hometown fans with some redemption after Utah failed to qualify for the Super Six. Her 9.95 was not only the top scorer, but her performance also received the loudest cheers. The biggest surprise came during the floor exercise. Freshman Marnie Ostrang from Bowling Green won on the last floor exercise of the competition. Three gymnasts shared the beam championship, Kiralee Hayashi, Andrea Pickens, and Teresa Kulikowski. Kiralee Hayashi, the co-captain from UCLA. Andrea Pickens, the outstanding freshman from the University of Alabama. And Teresa Kulikowski from Utah. And it was Kulikowski who stole the show in the all-round competition. She dominated all four events.
To know that all these people come to watch us and are supporting us and are so proud of us, it shows that all the hard work pays off, I think.
Teresa Kulikowski, the all-round champion, and we'll be back with the second half of our competition after this. Georgia has shown why they are the defending national champions, led by inspirational routines on the vault and bars by Karen Lynch. 1997 champion UCLA has moved into second place behind the grace and agility of junior Heidi Moneymaker. While third place Michigan is still close thanks to Sarah Kane, the Wolverines seeking their first national title. And Alabama has taken its lumps on the very difficult beam. Welcome back to the Huntsman Center in Salt Lake City, Utah, in the 1998 NCAA Women's Gymnastics Championship. Bill McAtee back with you along with Amanda Borden. And Amanda, we're midway through the team competition. Has the University of Georgia left the door open a little bit?
I think that Georgia wasn't quite as clean as they liked to be on bars. The door is definitely open. There's only 3 tenths between Georgia, who's in first, UCLA, who's in second, and Michigan, who's in third. So the door is definitely open now.
So if you're UCLA or you're Michigan, what are you thinking about right now?
They need to come out and hit their routines clean. Georgia as well needs to hit the beam or else it's out.
That beam always in the back of every team's mind. The fourth rotation looks like this. Michigan on the vault, UCLA on the bars, Georgia on the beam, and Alabama in the floor exercise. And up first for Michigan, Sarah Elizabeth Langford, a junior from Atlanta, Georgia.
Sarah will be performing a handspring pike front. Wow, great height, very clean. She did have a step on the landing, but it was a great vault. Watch the height she gets. Nice pike position. Just a small step on the landing.
And the score for Sarah Elizabeth Langford, a 9.75 for Michigan. Amanda Curry of Georgia is first up on the beam.
Flight series. She had a rough time on bars, and sometimes that can be very difficult coming back from a routine like that and coming on to the balance beam. So far, she looks like she's handling it well.
2 years ago, Georgia was in a similar position, but three falls on the beam cost them the national championship to UCLA.
Great routine so far, preparing for a dismount. Round off double full. Good start for Georgia.
Over on the floor exercise, this is Robin Hawkins of Alabama from Memphis, Tennessee, and Alabama trying to recover after the disappointing showing on the beam.
This is her second tumbling pass. Nice 2.5 twist.
Score on the beam, 9.875, so that's a good start. And Robin Hawkins, a 9.8 on the floor for Alabama. Meanwhile, UCLA is on the bars. Lena Dikteva.
Right into a giant blind, pike, Jaeger flip. Very clean so far. Nice full and back out, great landing. It's a very solid routine with very few deductions.
Lena has three wins on bars this year and was all Pac-10 in the all round. Another look at the dismount.
It's a full twist on the first flip. Landing.
And the score for Lena Dikteva, 9.9. Now, on the beam, Stacy Galloway of Georgia. Stacy from Canada, and she's a Canadian national champion in three of the disciplines.
Saw a slight wobble there. It actually broke the connection of her gym series, but she did have a backup connection, so that's not a problem. Just a small deduction.
In 1994, she won the Canadian National Championship on bars and floor. She finished second on the beam and third on the vault.
Getting ready for a dismount. Round off double tuck. Good landing.
So Georgia getting it done on the balance beam. Lisa Symes, senior from Michigan, is up next on the vault.
Another pipe.
The score for Stacy Galloway on the beam, 9.875. And for Lisa Symes in the vault, a 9.9. So that's good news for Michigan. Still a very tight competition. And coming up, freshman Andrea Pickens Heidi Moneymaker of UCLA and Sarah Kane when we come back to Salt Lake City. Back at the Huntsman Center in Salt Lake City. And for more in-depth gymnastics news, go on to the internet to cbs.sportsline.com. And there's Sam Uelman. She fractured a vertebrae in her neck during the practice session the day before the SECs, but she's on hand to help out. And injuries have been a problem for the University of Georgia.
Georgia is a dominant team, but Coach Yocklin said the biggest challenge this year was dealing with the injuries. They lost a lot of key players, as you can see.
But turning that into a positive, one of Georgia's mottos has been a wounded dog is a hungry dog. And up on the beam for Georgia, Christy Litchie.
Getting right into her tumbling series. A handspring layout, layout. Very solid. Christy is a competitor. She likes to go out. She likes to hit her routines. And you can tell that by the way she's attacking this routine right now. Into Sean Schmont, straddle quarter. Preparing for a dismount. They need a clean landing right here. Round off 1.5. Great job.
Dave Litchie applauding his daughter's routine and big smile from Christy. Christine Michaud of Michigan is up next on the vault.
Wow. A nice souk full, the perfect landing. Let's watch it again. She does a half on and a full twist off and doesn't even take a step.
The score for Michaud, a 9-9 for Michigan. So the Wolverines hanging in there. For Christy Litchie on the beam, 9.85. Heidi Moneymaker set on the bars now for UCLA. She was the 1998 NCAA champion on the bars. There's her mom, Casey, looking on.
Great heights. Right back up with the back uprise to handstand. Pike, Jaeger flip. Great routine so far. Ending with the double layout. Keep in mind she's landing on 2 sprained ankles. She did a great job of handling that.
She's performed so well, you almost forget about the ankle injuries that she's competing with.
Here's the dismount again. She did take a slight hop, but it was a great routine.
And the score for Heidi Moneymaker, 9.85. Now, Karen Litchie has been just about perfect. You see her scores thus far, 2 9.95s. And Karen is set for her beam routine.
Nice press mount. Karen is a very consistent competitor. Preparing for a tumbling series. Back handspring, layout, oh.
And that is a surprise.
Georgia hasn't had a mistake thus far, so this will be the score they want to drop.
Over on the floor, Andrea Pickens, there's what she's done so far. Andrea competing in her first NCAA national championship.
very clean.
Andrea Pickens from the University of Alabama. The score for Karen Litchie after the fall on the beam, 9.4.
You can actually see in her second back handspring, she's a little bit crooked as she takes off, and she just can't hold on.
And that's something that Dave Litchie's not used to seeing. Daughter Karen falling off the beam. But Georgia survives a fall on the beam. Still, that can unnerve and take its toll on a coach, Suzanne Yocholin. And the altitude continues to be a problem. Andrea Pickens with oxygen after her floor exercise routine. And during that routine, here was Sarah Kane from Michigan at the vault.
Yurchenko Arabian. She does a round off onto the board, back handspring onto the horse, and an Arabian off. That is a 10-0 start by Yuval.
The score for Sarah Kane, 9.825. So the standings after four rotations look like this. And the scoring average, Georgia, Michigan, and UCLA are tied. And here's Bonnie Bernstein, Suzanne Yocholin.
Suzanne Yocholin told me her gym dogs were tired because they competed the night session, the preliminaries, after going 49-275 on beam. They didn't look terribly tired.
Well, you don't have to have that much energy for balance beam, but they've definitely been digging so deep, and no one can ever convince me that emotion doesn't make a difference, because it has so far.
Suzanne, you're one event away from winning back-to-back national titles. What do you tell your girls to keep them focused?
It's not over till the fat lady sings. You just got to take it one routine at a time. We tried to stay on top of that the whole season. We're going to continue.
Great. Good luck, Sam. Thank you.
Georgia with the lead, and we'll be back after this message and a word from your local stations.
All the team for doing the laundry every week. Happy Mother's Day. I love you.
Happy Mother's Day, Mom. I love you.
Happy Mother's Day from Nebraska. We love you, Mom.
Two more rotations remaining. Georgia and Michigan have byes. Alabama on the vault. Arizona State on bars. UCLA on beam. And Nebraska in the floor exercise. University of Georgia looking on. They won a year ago by 1.5 points, and that's a remarkable margin of victory. Valerie Kondos, UCLA, won the national championship 2 years ago. Susie Erickson of UCLA is up on the beam. She's from Pomona, California. She has been extremely reliable for UCLA on the beam. She came into the national championships with a streak of 21 straight routines without a fall.
It's very important to put up a very consistent starter on beam. You want to come out, you want your team to feel confident and comfortable. Tumbling series, back handspring layout, step out. Gym series, switch sleep, split quarter. Dismount. Round off, double full. Great routine for UCLA.
UCLA just hoping that Georgia falters a little bit, and this helps.
Flight series with a back handspring layout, step out. Done perfectly.
The score for Susie Erickson, 9.9. There's Sarah Patterson. Alabama's in fourth place after four rotations. Dara Stewart of Alabama is next on the vault. That's what she's done so far.
High handspring front,
Doesn't look like she had too many deductions there. Legs are nice and tight. Stuck landing.
And 9.825 for Dara Stewart of Alabama. Elizabeth Reed is up next on bars. She was an All-American in this event last year and has shown a very distinctive style.
When you see Elizabeth Reed, you think of beauty. Movement is just so graceful, and she's so, you know, either she's like a fine race car. Either she's on all engines, or she's off. There's no in between with Liz.
And you never know exactly what you're going to get from Elizabeth Reed.
Let's hope she's on here today. She has an incredible routine. Opening with a Stalder Tkachev, something we haven't seen. She's another unusual move coming up. Giant blind, front giant right here. She shoots through, dislocates her shoulders into inverted giants. Right into a front 1.5. Great job.
Elizabeth Reed from Arizona State.
Look closely at her shoulders. They're actually inverted. And she immediately taps into a front 1.5. Small hop in the landing.
And the score for Reed, 9.9. Over on the beam, the look on Kiralee Hayashi's face tells the story. A 9.3 for the co-national champion on the beam.
Watch her shoulders right here. They twist. She has no shot.
The reaction of her parents.
Oh my God.
It's a disappointment for the Hayashis and for UCLA. And that puts the pressure on Lena Dekhtaeva. Remember a year ago, UCLA fell 3 times on the beam, and that probably cost them the national championship to Georgia.
Tumbling series, back handspring layout. Nicely done.
Once again, 6 competitors. They count the best 5, so another fall, and they'll have to count that.
Series back walkover to a stag jump. Very solid routine so far. Coming to the dismount. Round off full. Great landing.
So Lena Dekhtaeva survives the pressure and comes through for UCLA. Coming up, Andrea Pickens on the ball when we return to Salt Lake City. Back in Salt Lake City of the 1999 NCAA Women's Gymnastics Championships, our leaders, the University of Georgia. They're still on a bye along with Michigan. And the score for Lena Dekhtaeva, 9.85. And Amy Shelton of Arizona State is up next on bars. ASU trying to move up out of 5th place.
You can see Amy's arm is wrapped up, her left elbow. She actually has torn ligaments in that arm. Hop full, right into a huge Tkachev.
Arizona State edged out LSU for the final spot, Super 6.
Great job. Amy's only a junior, but she's actually graduating this year, so this is her last routine.
An emotional moment for Amy Shelton. And a nice effort from Arizona State on the bars. Over on the vault, Wynn Spydal from Alabama.
She'll be performing a Yurchenko entry vault. With an Arabian off. Great landing. Wow.
There's her mother, Kim. And a hug. This is Alabama's final event. Amy Shelton, a 9-9 on the bars for Arizona State. And for Gwen Spydal, 9.85 on the vault. And it looks like the beam has gotten UCLA again. Mohini Bhardwaj, a 9.65. Here's what happened.
Punch front mount. She was a little bit crooked. It's a big deduction, but she did everything she could to stay on.
Valerie Kondos has been through this before. Luisa Portocarrero from Guatemala is on the beam now for UCLA. She was a member of the Guatemalan Olympic team in 1992.
The pressure is on. They need a clean, solid routine, and Luisa knows how to do that. Here comes our tumbling series. Back handspring, lay out, step out. Oh, it's a front aerial, foot just didn't even land on the beam.
And this has become a nightmare for UCLA. They're going to have to count two bad scores, and that will take them out of the running for the national championship.
Sometimes the most difficult part about beam is finishing the routine after you've had a fall. Luisa is doing a great job. Dismounting with a gainer full. You can see the disappointment on her face. Okay. Watch here. Watch her foot as it hits the beam. Slips right off. What's difficult about that move is it's a blind move. You have no idea where your foot's landing.
Fortunate to avoid serious injury. Her score, 9.375. Andrea Pickens is up for Alabama on the vault.
Wow. Yurchenko Arabian now had great height and a great landing. Watch the block off the horse. Nice and tight in the air.
Alabama came into this rotation in fourth place, and they've had an outstanding vault. Andrea Pickens, 9.85, and that moves Alabama ahead of UCLA. Both teams have a bye in the final rotation, so it has been a disappointing day for the UCLA Bruins. The standings after five rotations. Georgia leads in the scoring average, and here's Bonnie Bernstein with Alabama's Sarah Patterson.
Your Alabama squad finished up real strong on ball. You were just having a little team powwow. What'd you tell them?
Well, I told them I'm so proud of the job they did. We are the youngest team on the floor here at the national championship. Of 24 routines, 19 came from freshmen and sophomores. I just told them that they did an awesome job and that we're going to be a contender for years to come, and I just couldn't be any more pleased with our performance.
Congratulations. Thanks.
Thank you.
Thank you, Bonnie. So Georgia and Michigan get set for the final rotation, battling for the national championship. Back at the Huntsman Center with the national championship on the line, and it's come down to a battle between Georgia and Michigan. Alabama with the lead temporarily. They look on with a sixth rotation bye. Nebraska will be on vault, Michigan on bars, Arizona State on beam, and the floor exercise, the University of Georgia. Bev Plocke, the head coach at Michigan, trying to win her first national championship. Erin McWatt, freshman, will be up first on bars for Michigan.
Opening with a nice uprise to handstand. Acquired release move, Jaeger flip. Michigan is known for their clean routines. Erin has done a great job so far coming down to the dismount. Double tuck, great landing.
Every routine at this stage is crucial.
Here's a replay of the dismount. Double tuck, stuck landing.
And the score for Erin McWatt, a 9.8. Meanwhile, early trouble for Georgia in the floor exercise. Caroline Harris with a 9.55.
She had a little bit too much energy on her first tumbling pass. A double pike. She actually bounced back and out of bounds. So she got a deduction not only for the hop, but also a tenth of a deduction for stepping out of bounds.
And concern on the face of Suzanne Yocklin. But she's got Christy Litchie up next on the floor. That has to make her feel a little bit better.
Christy's a very strong tumbler, opening with a nice double pike. The team in the background. This is probably the event that the team has the most fun on. They get to clap, they get to cheer loud, have some fun. Here comes her second tumbling pass. Similar to the first, but in a tuck position. Nice double tuck. See, her legs are a little bit apart. We call that a cowboy. Sometimes that's a little bit, we use that a little bit for some extra rotation.
Who finished fourth in the all-round competition, and that's just what Georgia needed.
Here's her first tumbling pass. A double back in the pike position.
Dave Litchie likes it. And the score for Christy Litchie, 9.85. Over on the bars, Lisa Symes, 9.35, and that's trouble for Michigan.
The trouble came on her dismount. Double layout, just not quite enough rotation. Her knees touched down, and that is a 3/10 of a deduction.
While Christy Litchie was on the floor, here was Bridget Knabley of Michigan on bars.
She's an interesting opening to this routine. She mounts with a free hip hex. Actually moves from the low bar to the high bar, right into an uprise to handstand. Nice to Tkachev. Into another release move, Ginger. They need a good landing right here. Giant full right into a nice double back. Great job.
So Bridget Knabley comes through for Michigan. Over on the floor, underway, Suzanne Sears, sophomore from Georgia.
First tumbling pass, front through a double tuck.
Suzanne performed in the closing ceremonies of the 1996 Olympics in Atlanta and also during Super Bowl 28 in Atlanta. She was also an All-American in the floor exercise last year. So now the scores, Bridget Knebley at 9.85 on the bars for Michigan. Suzanne Sears, 9.825 for Georgia on the floor. Karen Litchie is coming up next for Georgia, and Nikki Peters for Michigan when we return. Back in Salt Lake City, there's the Gym Dogs rooting section. It's come down to Georgia and Michigan. And more and more, it's become apparent that Alabama looks like we'll have to settle for third place. While Arizona State has helped themselves, they've just concluded their final routine of the day. And apparently, because of Elizabeth Reed's effort, they will pass UCLA and move into fourth place.
We were told she could be great, and she was great today.
Nebraska has not had a lot of highlights, but one of them came from Heather Brink. This is Heather in the vault.
Wow, Yurchenko 1.5. There's not a lot that I need to say about that vault. It's a very difficult vault. Starts at a 10-0. Round off entry. Coming off, she does a 1.5 twist. Nearly perfect landing.
And the score for Heather Brink was a 9.95. Now Bev Plocke hoping to close the gap on Georgia. Sarah Kane is up on bars for Michigan.
Sarah's had a great competition here today. Opening her routine. Right back up to a handstand. Second release move, a pike Jaeger flip. Getting ready for a dismount. Nice double front half.
Remember, both teams have a bad score, so neither team can afford a letdown. Floor for Georgia, Stacy Galloway.
Second tumbling pass here. Double tuck. Kind of close to the boundaries there. Georgia doesn't need to be stepping out at this point.
Trying to win back-to-back national championships. Only one other school has done that, the University of Utah.
Getting ready for her last pass. Stacy was actually struggling with this in warm-ups, so let's see what happens.
Stacy Galloway of the University of Georgia. And a big hug from Suzanne Yocklin.
What do you guys say?
Meanwhile, on the bars, the score for Sarah Kane, 9.875. For Stacey Galloway on the floor, 9.85. And the pressure is on Nikki Peters. Anything less than a 9.85 for Nikki Peters would give Georgia the national championship.
Nikki is the Big Ten bars champion. She scored a perfect 10 there. Michigan could use that here right now, and they could put the pressure on Georgia. Nice Heidinger. It's going to come down to the dismount right here. Nice double layout. Great landing. It's going to be close.
She needs a 9.85 or better to keep Michigan's hopes alive.
Here's the dismount again. Double layout. Perfect landing, not one step.
Her teammates know how important this is. And sensing her score will be good enough. And it is good enough. Almost perfect. A 9.95 for Nikki Peters. So now the task falls appropriately to Karen Litchie. Karen needs a 9.675 to clinch the national title for the University of Georgia.
Watch this first tumbling pass. Pike full in. Great landing. She's using Georgia's fight song. And tumbling pass. Front Rudy, immediate layout step out. This is Karen's final routine of a wonderful college career.
Celebration has started for Georgia.
And prelims on this pass, her legs actually buckled, but today she finished strong.
Sister Christy couldn't even watch the last tumbling pass. She heard the cheers, opened her eyes, and she joined everyone else celebrating the victory from Georgia. Dave Litchie enjoying the moment with his daughters. And now the score for Karen Litchie. It's official, 9.95, and Georgia has won the national championship. And we'll be back to talk to the winners after this.
CBS Sports presents the NCAA Women's Gymnastics Championships. Sponsored by Scott's Lawn Products. Old Spice High Endurance Deodorant and Antiperspirant. Powerful protection for men. And by Goodyear, innovators of Run Flat technology.
A look at the final standings. Georgia, Michigan, Alabama, Arizona State, UCLA, and Nebraska.
We got five. She made it. We got five.
The drive for five is complete, and Gunther Litchie on hand to see his granddaughters, and here's how it looked through Grandpa Cam. Final moments of Georgia's national championship, and here's Bonnie Bernstein with Suzanne Yocklin and the winning Georgia Gym Dogs.
All right, Suzanne Yocklin, congratulations.
nation's first back-to-back titles for Georgia. Now, at the beginning of the year, you expressed a little bit of concern, saying, well, this team might not have the intensity or the chemistry of last year. How have they grown?
Actually, I just said that they had so much heart and so much mental toughness, and actually their injuries just propelled them to keep going and keep going. And they never quit. It's like a wounded dog just licks his wounds and keeps going.
One of many mottos for the team this year. Okay, Karen Litchie, one of the four seniors this year. During your career, so many accolades, a perfect 40. Second title for you is the better way you could have sent you and your teammates out?
Oh, definitely not. Yeah, this is the greatest one because we've been through so many ups and downs this season, and everyone has put in the time and the effort all the way from the freshmen to the seniors, and I just love every single one of these teammates, and go Dawgs!
Now, I've heard rumors, Jenny Bethard, another one of the seniors, that she's kind of taken after Jamal Anderson of the Atlanta Falcons. He has an end zone dance called the Dirty Bird. I hear you have a dirty dog, so I'm going to have to call you.
And our congratulations as well to the University of Georgia, an outstanding showing from Michigan as the Wolverines finish second.
Great way for the Litchie sisters to finish their career together.
What you guys did tonight. I'm so proud.
Hug from their father, Dave. Coming up next on CBS, the LPGA, the Mercury Title Holders Championship from Daytona Beach, Florida. So for Amanda Borden and Bonnie Bernstein, I'm Bill McAtee. Thanks for being with us. So long from Salt Lake City.